causing muscle apnea, especially in REM sleep. It also causes an increase in airflow resistance, decrease in functional residual capacity, as well as the pooling of secretions. So all of this happens when we sleep. Except in a normal individual, this doesn't cause too much problems. But if there's an impaired breathing, then it becomes a problem. In patients with COPD, restricted lung disease, and it becomes a real problem. This is my daughter, okay? There is nothing in the world I will not do for my daughter. If there is something that's choking her to sleep, if there is something that's causing her to not breathe, to be saturated, I will do everything I can. But the problem is, if this happens during sleep, does it mean that you should not care for it? Just because mawala yung makikita? Most of the referrals you get is yung pasyente yung admits ICU na butang monitor. Uy, hindi na yung kasing nilisa. Okay? So the problem is we have to think about our patient not only when they're awake, but when they are also asleep. Okay? This is just to wake you up. Okay? This is a sort of a question to see if you are sleeping well and you are waking well. Okay? This is a tool that we call the Epworth Sleepiness Scale Score to assess sleepiness. Okay? We will have you answer this and you will see who of you needs a sleep consultation. How likely are you to doze off or fall asleep in the following situations in contrast to feeling just tired? This refers to your usual way of life in recent times. Even if you have not done some of these things recently, try to work out how they would have affected you. Use the pharynx scale to choose the most appropriate number for each situation. 0 would never doze, 1 slight, 2 moderate, 3 high chance. Okay, put a pen and paper that will add the score afterwards and see who of you are actually getting enough sleep. Okay? Sitting and reading. Dila ka buo, makatulog, magbasa. I think in medical school, more than 3 man.
That's
right. Sitting and reading. But medical school, 3. Okay? 0, 1, 2, and 3 right now. Okay? So you're sitting and you're reading. Watching TV. Pila ka buo, makatulog, makatulog TV. Okay? Sitting in acting in a public place like this. Okay? Who of you would snore when you're sitting here right now listening to a lecture? 0, 1, 2, or 3. As a passenger, you drive ka padung Davao. No? For an hour, ha? So, kung 4 hours, makatulog, magigitay ka, no? As a passenger in a car for an hour without a break. Okay? How likely are you gonna fall asleep? If right now, I let you lie down, how likely are you able to go to sleep? Sitting and talking to someone. Okay, in all journey, na kung mga pasyente nga, pukawang bigay mo kayo, magsigit ka to, pag magsigit ka sa surya. No, ako, pukawang mo kayo, sa mga tayo ng problema, ako. Okay, 0, 1, 2, and 3. Sitting quietly after a lunch with alcohol like this. Okay, how likely are you gonna fall asleep? And the last question is, in a car. You're riding in a car, muno na sa traffic light, how likely are you gonna fall asleep? Okay? If you add all of that, and your answer is 10 or less, then you're normal. If you're more than 10, that means that there is a problem with sleep. Okay? For residents, the reason why you're sleepy is lack of sleep. Okay? So more than that, usual for residents, but... So these are the different things that cause sleep. So we're going to talk about sleep-related breathing disorders. And the one that we're going to be talking about is obstructive sleep apnea, okay, which is the most common sleep-related breathing disorder and the most common reason for referral to a sleep disorder center. Obstructive sleep apnea. Okay? I present one of the patients I saw first when I started practice. 37-year-old Asian gentleman. Loud snoring and gasping for breath at night was the chief complaint. You know who brought the chief complaint? The wife. Okay? The patient doesn't really care if he snores. He sleeps for 8 hours at night, does not feel refreshed upon waking up, wakes up around twice a night, takes a nap during night time, He said he's not, okay, and his wife cannot sleep. Oh, aimless happy, my husband's snoring was so loud that I couldn't get to sleep myself. Worst of all, however, were the constant recurring moments when his breathing stopped altogether and the room became deadly still. I was afraid he was suffocating. To kusukin mo ako kung ano hindi mo sa akin ng ulam na tikuka, bura siya di ito. Marag, hindi sa akin dati pag ako minawin. Okay? So, let's talk about obstructive sleep apnea. Apnea comes from the Greek word absence of airflow or cessation of airflow. So there's no breathing. Obstructive because there's an ongoing effort to breathe except something is obstructing the airway. So that's why no breathing goes in. Intermittent, okay, but permanent, patay, right? Okay. So this is how usually what happens to obstructive sleep apnea. Usually there's an anatomical problem, either in the retrolingual area or the retropalatal area, which causes numbing the airways. When they're awake, the muscles keep the airway open. When one goes to sleep, the muscles, the back of the throat, the tongue, the pharynx, relaxes. And the narrow airway becomes even narrower. So the smaller the opening usually that you have to breathe through, the louder the snore you make. Okay. So usually, what we're worried about is this thing. It closes off. The typical snore of obstructive sleep apnea is crescendo snoring followed by a pause like this. So sa roomie na kong doktor, may sleep apnea ko, ito gaya mo kong yung ginawa ko, kawang rin ako, ha? Matay na ko. We hear about Apnea syndrome. This is actually based on the paper by Charles Dickens published in 1837, the Apnea papers, okay? Then that boy, said the old man, he's gone to sleep again. Very extraordinary boy, said Mr. Pickwick. Does he always sleep in this way? Sleep, said the old gentleman. He's always asleep, goes on errands, fast asleep, and snores as he waits at table. Okay? So this actually, Mr. Pickwick was not the one with Pickwickian syndrome. It was a boy in the Pickwickian papers. Okay? Pickwickian syndrome is different from obstructive sleep apnea. It's a whole gradation. Okay, you have snoring, mild sleep apnea, moderate sleep apnea, severe sleep apnea. The worst would be Pickwickian syndrome where they have hyperventilation, desaturation, restricted lung pathology during the day. Okay, these are the